we're up here in Princeton, Wisconsin this weekend. We're at Uncle Jim's property. And I didn't really plan on taking any videos, but we're just having too much fun to not record stuff. So Riley, she's discing up the backfield or the garden. And she changed out a battery on a 753 this morning, took that for a ride. And took a 400 Suburban for a spin. I was able to ride on a 46 Pond lever steer tractor. We've had the McLean out, Radford, and just having a good old time. We're looking forward to a couple trail rides maybe. And of course there's gonna be food. There's always good food when you're at Uncle Jim's. So thanks Jim and Dan and Cindy. And it's been nice to meet so many other people too. We're gonna have some fun.
Pretty hard starting too, huh?
Wow.
The carburetor is not quite right, but...
This is a Pond lever steer tractor, a 1946, signed by Mr. Cecil Pond himself. That plate's been clear coated real good, just because that was a Sharpie, he said. And this is just a sweet old tractor. This is what started it all. This is old irons, Rob's. And it is just one sweet running machine. One pull, fired right up. You see Cindy's 702. With a silver base, and blue and charcoal flames, and a candy apple red tint clear coat. Just a beautiful machine. That Jim Kemp stack muffler, we'll probably hear it later, but man, it sounds good. I hear people tell me all the time that they sound good, and it sure does. Here's Dan Acto's Radford diesel 1045 that he built. He sure does a good job. and clean.
Looks like a 1-inch.
This pulley is smaller.
Oh, and the steering,
a lot smaller.
You can see
this tractor goes way faster.
There's two drag
identical
belts.
Landlords. Yeah.
Have you guys ever
and
heard of
steering will limit the power to the inside wheel?
207, I
and that acts as the differential.
7 in the yellow and white.
It's 207.
And
okay, but
it's got
the
chain steer. Your chain's wrapped around the pulley.
Talking to himself.
Yeah.
So Riley got done disking, so she dragged it with a box spring mattress, and it looks pretty good. She smoothed out the trail, so we can go on a trail ride later. It's good for 60 mile an hour, Dan. Took us a trail ride, and now I'm walking. Cause Uncle Jim told me make sure they have enough gas, and I thought one did, and I thought wrong. So I was wrong about the whole matter. If you see that yellow wire there, that's what's sending power to the amp meter, and I'm guessing that might be the problem. Trip to Jim and Cindy's was awesome, and we even did a little horse trading that I really didn't expect, but I came home with a 401, and let's see, there's the serial number, and it's got a Clinton on it, and he says it's not the right engine. Good enough if I can get it running. It's been sitting a little while. The axle seals are going to need to be gone through and redo the bushings in the tubes. You can see that one's pretty greasy. But awesome time. We had a blast. 380 miles each way. And I guess that's what I came home with to prove it. So thanks again. Everybody over in Wisconsin, we always have a fun time when we come visit.